shockingly not going to draw Yanto today. This has to be so surprising for everyone. Yes, I am going to make a Weevil Monster High, because you know, they make those like collector dolls that are like characters from horror movies, and they could make a Weevil one. I think that would be so cool. I know they're not going to, but it would be cool. So I am going to make the Weevil one, or like draw it, not make it as an actual doll. I could, but and I want to make a Blowfish one as well, like a two-pack, like Weevil and Blowfish. That would be cool. And they kind of have those like improved versions of all the outfits. Like the Chucky ones were clearly just like vibes. They're not really like perfect reconstructions of the characters' outfits. So I can kind of get funky with the clothes on the Weevil. There's a bug on my screen. Let's take the pencils that I tested last time. Is that the one or is this the one? I don't remember which one I used last time. I think it was. Yeah, it was this one. There's another bug? Stay off my screen. And I'm going to try to get like the proportions right so that it looks kind of like actual doll artwork. But I can't promise anything because they are so skinny. I'm not used to drawing this skinny anymore. No, I like bugs and I don't want to kill them, but if they keep going on my screen, I'm going to have to kill them. Like, usually I try to just put them outside or something, but. Like, the most annoying thing is when there's a wasp that comes into my room, so I try to like guide it outside, but it won't listen to me. It won't like try to stay with the sheet of paper that I'm using to put it outside. Like, it keeps trying to fly back to the window, but it can't get through the glass because it's glass. But it keeps trying, and I'm like, no, please go this way, and they won't listen to me. I mean, they can't actually understand speech, but like, I wish they could. drawing is going to be so weirdly proportioned because I'm really not used to this. Hi! So skinny. I remember at one point my mom telling someone that she was like not buying me Bratz dolls because they're unrealistic and that they set like bad standards or something. I don't remember exactly. Like, girl, you were buying me Monster High dolls? They're just as unrealistically proportioned as Bratz, like. I mean, I don't think like the fact that they're monsters was the problems, or humans, or it was more like in terms of body types. Like, yeah, Bratz is skinny with huge feet and huge heads, but so is Monster High. Like, have you seen them? And well, I also remember, well, I've seen a lot of people say they're like kind of promoting anorexia or something. No, I remember playing with those things when I was 10 and I did not think that I wanted to be skinny like them, but I don't know. It's like, yeah, Barbie's not realistic either, but like a cartoon isn't realistic either. Like, Dora isn't realistic. Like, she has a huge head and no child is like, oh, I want my head to be big like Dora. I wanted to be an anime cat girl at some point. But yeah, obviously I knew it wasn't possible. I wanted pink hair and cat ears and a tail. Yeah, cat ears would be cool. There's probably people who want something different from cat ears. Like dog ears or wings or something. But also, like, clearly Monster High was inspired by like fashion illustrations, and when you look at those, they are also very skinny and unrealistic because it's more about the vibe than really portraying how the body is going to look. It's like about the vibes and about the clothes. It's not about the people. Though I do like that they're doing more diverse body types in the new generation of Monster High. Like, I think that is really important, but I don't think the old ones were promoting anorexia or something more than other dolls on the market. Yay! Well, you will see. I can keep talking and you can see if you hear me or not. I wanted to put some music on, but I did not feel like figuring it out today. I'll try next time or something, I don't know if I remember. maybe make that chest different shaped because it looks weird right now. I already know how I want the weevil's clothes to be like, but I don't know if I should give her hair or not. Because obviously weevils don't really have hair. I mean, they do, but look at that, that's not fashionable. But also, I don't know if it would be weird to have a bald monster high. Like, I think that might be cool, but I don't know. I'll see. I'll figure it out on the way. Also, there have been people who've tried making dolls that were like realistically proportioned, but it was always kind of just like, oh, this is the opposite of Barbie, and their only defining characteristic was being the opposite of Barbie and stuff like that. So they did not really have an identity as a brand, so it did not really work. Hi, I am drawing Collector Weevil Monster High. Because I think they should make one. They're not going to make one, but we can dream. Yeah, I'll leave the hand for later. I think people will say that it's like the dolls causing children to have body image issues and stuff, but clearly it's not just a doll that's going to cause that, it's like a wider problem in society. Like, when you have your parents like commenting that you're too fat or something, or too ugly, or obviously this is going to affect you. I don't think just playing with a doll that's skinny is going to make you think you're too fat. It's like an entire society problem, seeing people get called too fat all the time when you're growing up and stuff like that. Like, yeah. And it is good that they're putting more different body types in dolls and stuff like that, because it is important for children to have dolls that look like themselves, that look like their parents, their friends and stuff like that, instead of all being like the same generic model, you know? But also, toys are not the be end, be all of life. I don't know if that expression is right, but they're not everything. Like, there's an entire culture that children live in that is like this. Like, I remember I watched a documentary made on how Mattel started making the curvy Barbies, and in it they explained how earlier, like years before, Mattel had done like tests to see how little girls reacted to a curvier Barbie, and they were like, oh, but the children are always calling her the fat Barbie and being mean and stuff, so that means we should not make curvy Barbies. But the thing is, like, children act this way for a reason. It's not just because the doll is fat, it's because there's a whole culture of fat phobia everywhere, and obviously it affects the children. Like, that it's that easy. And having a curvier Barbie is like part of making fat bodies be more normal in the eyes of people. So being like, oh, we can't make a fat Barbie because children won't like her, is stupid. And they're not even that fat. They're like more like average, honestly. Well, they're Barbie. They're not like... they already don't have real people proportions. But the documentary was always kind of being very nice to Mattel, because obviously if you want their collaboration on something, you can't just go around making a documentary that this is them the entire way. So it was kind of like, oh, isn't it groundbreaking that Mattel is making fat dolls now? Woo! Like, no, they should have done this earlier. This is not... it's not that incredible. But yeah, it's like the Barbie movie, where even the CEO of Mattel isn't actually mean, like, oh, I'm actually a nice person who wants to see little girls follow their dreams. And it's just like, yeah, they really could not make the CEO of Mattel be the bad guy if they wanted to use the Barbie name. I'm thinking the hand like this on this side, and on the other side maybe holding like a bag or something. That could work well. Yeah, I don't know what I'm gonna do for the shoes though. Like, I know the clothes, but I don't know the shoes. Good luck. Do not die. Or don't die too much, I guess. Hi. Is this head symmetrical? Probably not. Absolutely not symmetrical. I don't feel like fixing it right now. Let's make it a little bit smaller. And I'm gonna draw a bit of the glosses first. I was thinking like that jumpsuit they have, but that's like shorts and short sleeves. Because I thought it would be nice. One thing I think that is disappointing is that they only use the G1 body molds for the Collector Monster High dolls. So they all have to be the super skinny ones when they have all those new body molds that they could easily use them because they have them made, but they just won't. And it is a bit disappointing because when you get characters like Tiffany Valentine, you see she is not fat, because honestly, no, she's not that fat. Like, I know people will call anything, any actor that isn't like stick thin fat, but she's not that fat. Yeah, you have to be realistic, but she is, like I said, not as thick thin as some other actresses. And well, on the Monster High doll, she is just a super skinny body mold, and so it's a bit disappointing because they could have made an effort and they didn't, and they probably won't. And I know the collector market prefers the G1 aesthetic, I guess, because of the nostalgia and all, but it's still disappointing that like they could be doing more and they aren't. Same with the holiday dolls. Like, those are also aimed at collectors, but they're not as expensive, so they could make use of the newer molds, and they don't. And honestly, like, collectors aren't swapping clothes around. So you can't even be like, oh, it's for the clothes or whatever, because you know collectors are not doing that. Like, if they take the dolls out of the box, that's already a miracle. And I am so mad that I missed the Kree Production Ghoulia release, because I wanted to buy her, but my card does not work online. On those, you know the thing where you put the card number and the expiration date, those do not work with me. And I tried to ask my friend, like, hey, could you buy her for me? Because my friend is staying in Canada right now, so I thought it would be like cheaper. But basically, by the time she texted back, and while we were like talking about this, she sold out like in less than 24 hours. And it was so upsetting. But I know they're doing like a re-release of the dolls from the first reproduction wave, so like Draculaura, Claudine, Laguna and Frankie. I know they're doing like a re-release of those in September, so I really hope they're gonna do a re-release of the second wave as well, because I need a new Ghoulia. Like, I still have mine. But she, like, her hair isn't in exactly the right hairstyle anymore, because I had to undo it to wash it, and I changed her clothes. I don't want to get all the pieces back together again, because they are on other dolls, and I like the way those other dolls look like this. Well, it's a whole thing. So like, I just wanted like one, so I could have like the original look, and then the restyle I did. But no, I have to just keep the one I have. And yeah, people who are reselling her now are really doing it at insane prices, like hundreds of euros, which is really unfair. It's like, you know, she was only on Amazon US and Canada, so you know a lot of Europeans probably couldn't really get her because it would have been a bit of a struggle for them. And instead of having like resellers who are like nice and order the doll to make it easier for those in Europe to get her, no, it's people who bought a bunch of them and sell them for 250 euros on Vinted. Like, it really sucks. Like, they should like make, like, if you sold her for 50 euros, I would be like, okay, like, it's about 40 USD including shipping to get her from the US to Europe, and I would like, okay, like you get a 10 euro margin on this, fine, I accept it, like it's reasonable, but like 250, that's like 200 bucks straight in your pocket. I'm not buying this, no way. Especially because you know that collector Golia they released last year, that was like fan club exclusive, so you had to pay a membership of $10 a year to get her, and she was the first release for the membership thing, so it was like a brand new thing. Everyone had to pay the membership to get her, and then she was $50 or $60. So she was $50 or $60, I think, plus the $10 membership. So that's $60 or $70 in total. I found her on Vinted, and I paid 70 euros total for the doll, including shipping. So clearly, it is possible to resell these dolls at a reasonable price. She's just missing one earring, and she's like reboxed, so she's not in the original pose. But I was going to unbox her anyway. And I am glad I got her, honestly, because if I had the money at that point to buy her on Mattel Creations, it would have been like an insane price, because shipping, import fees, it would not have been good. It would have been so much more than 70 euros. So I am so fucking glad I got her, but I am sad I did not get Kree Production Golia. I don't have the doll yet because she's been sent on Tuesday this week because of Easter, and last time I checked she was still in Spain. I can check the tracking now, actually, hold on, because I know they work on Saturdays as well. Track parcel, because I know they work on Saturdays but not on Sundays, so I'm gonna see if she's moved from Spain. Please be a little bit closer to me. Nope, she's still in Spain. Well, the planned delivery time is between April 8 and 10, and I hope it's 8. I want her as soon as possible, please. But yes, I hate resellers like everyone else does, I guess. But also the thing is, people who missed the doll are going to buy from resellers. So those resellers, they keep making money, so they keep doing it. And it's so annoying, because like, my friend who wanted to buy her for me, like she checked Amazon, like just after she sold out, and the only listing was like 90 bucks. And obviously Amazon isn't gonna put a stop to this, because it makes them money as well. Because I don't think, well, I imagine Amazon takes a margin on the things you list on their platform, even if they're not the ones selling, or else there would be no point in them doing that. But it's so upsetting, like, we did have like an entire day pretty much to buy her, but that's still kind of short notice. And also, like, there's people who got sent like a different doll, like someone ordered Golia and got Spectra instead or something like that. So like, if that had happened to me, and she was sold out so you couldn't get another one, I would have been so fucking pissed off. Like, I think I might have actually started killing people. Because, like, if she's sold out, you can't even return her to get the correct doll, because there's no more. You can die, that's all. That would suck so bad. Yeah, I hope Mattel sees like how quickly the sold out and thinks, oh, I'm gonna do a re-release of this wave. At least Golia, please. People don't even like G3 Golia. Cause with like Frankie, well, Draculaura is always the fan favorite anyway, so everyone wants her. But like Claudine, Frankie, Laguna, people also like the G3 versions. So even if, yeah, they're going crazy over the reproduction dolls, they still like the new dolls, so they can still buy the new dolls and like them. But people really dislike the new Golia. So they don't really care about getting her new dolls, they're only interested in G1 Golia. Which is sad. I don't like that they made G3 Golia speak, because I think they could have really, like, they want to go for like diversity and all. They could have used this to like, they could have just like had a non-speaking character who uses like AAC or sign language or something like that. Like, that could have worked really well, but they didn't. They decided, oh, she's going to speak now, and I don't like it. She only made zombie noises before, and it's like zombie is like a language or something, and it was cool. Like, people understood her, but the difference that people have explained is that in G1, it was sometimes a lot less character motivated, you know? Like, you had plots going on and all, but it stayed around the main four or five characters, and Golia wasn't really part of those main characters. Like, she was pretty present because she was like Cleo's best friend and all, but she was mostly more of a supporting character. So she would like be here, do some smart nerd thing while making zombie noises. And like for short scenes, they could just have a character repeat everything she said, basically. Like, there's one movie, I don't remember which one it is exactly. She's like doing her thing on the computer and going, well, zombie noise. And Abby is next to her and is like saying out loud everything. She's like, oh, the comet is approaching the planet. We only have 2 days left. Like, and like, no one speaks like that. No one is repeating entire sentences only when they speak to one person in particular. But they had to do that because she does not speak English. She speaks zombie. But you know, with the new Monster High trying to be for like diversity and all, they could have just used like sign language with an interpreter, or like AAC, even like a tablet or something that she would use to communicate. Like, that would have worked so well, and it doesn't need to be difficult. Or, and yeah, and they could have still had plots of Golia doing stuff, but just not being someone who speaks English, like vocally, you know? That would have worked so well, I think. And it's a bit disappointing that they did not do that. And I have not watched the new show yet, but I do look a bit at people, at what people say about it. But I like new Golia's design. People say they don't really like it. I like it. I know people complain about the pink, but apparently pink is an evil color, and any doll with pink is like forcing pink into the design or whatever. But when every single doll has blue in it, it's not a problem, apparently. Like, some of those criticisms are pretty wild. But yeah, the skirt, I'm not a fan of the skirt. Hold on, I'll get the picture and it will be clearer. Like, I'm not a fan of this skirt. But that's easy to change, especially when you're a collector of dolls. Like, you end up with a shit ton of clothes laying around, and they fit Barbie clothes a lot better now than they did before, since they have less skinny bodies. But yeah, I'm not a big fan of the skirt. But that's all. That's the only thing I want to change. I've seen people put her in shorts or in different skirts, in pants. It works perfectly. But people don't like her, and I don't understand. I fucking love the jacket with the brain pattern. I love the boots. I love the accessories. People are a bit too critical sometimes. And people have complained about the eyes. They're more like, hold on, new image coming. did not work. Like, the eyes are more wide set than before. But like, first of all, she's supposed to be wearing glasses. It's a lot less noticeable with the glasses on. Like, honestly, when she's got the glasses on, you can't tell. And also, like, having unique facial features and face molds for each doll was kind of what made Monster High unique. What made it like special. Like, you know, Spectra has those like sunken in cheeks. Abby had an underbite that was pretty noticeable. Like, they made an effort to make the faces a bit unique. And I don't know why, but now people just want everyone to be like this. Like, they want the diverse body types, but they don't want the diverse faces anymore, I guess. Like, they don't like that the characters have thicker eyebrows than they used to, even though it's really not that noticeable. They don't like Gulia having wide set eyes. I've also seen people complain about how G1 Laguna had those big wide set eyes as well. But like, she's a fish. Like, personally, I think it's disappointing that in the reproductions, Laguna's eyes are like less big than they used to. Like, this is supposed to be a fish. It makes sense for her to have big round eyes. Like, yeah, she has big round eyes that look a bit silly, but she's a fish. It makes sense. Like, and it makes sense for a zombie to have kind of that look as well, I guess. Like, the vibes fit. So it's really like, people will find any reason to complain. I am also guilty of this. I love complaining. But like, I've also seen people complain that the Monster Ball line of G3 was too 80s. Like, it is 80s inspired. Of course it looks like it's from the 80s. What are you thinking? Anyway. I've also seen a leak going around of possible new real drama dolls. It was posted on April 1st, I think, or April 2nd, so I'm not sure if I can trust it. But if it is true that Golia is getting a real drama release, I am going to be mad about not being able to get her. Like, I know this already. If she's on Amazon US, it might be possible. Like, if I can keep the money aside for her. But if she's not on Amazon, if it's like Mattel Creations only, I will die, because I will not be able to get her. And I will fucking die, because the real drama dolls, they're like the core dolls of G1. But they are like black and white with an accent color each. So they each have like streaks of hair in that color and accents on their clothes in that color. And not only Golia is my favorite, but her accent color that was apparently on the leaks is red. Red is my favorite color. Like, please, I need this doll. I need it to live. Give it to me. I think Mattel should send me every single doll for free. I'm not an influencer or anything. I just deserve it. For all the bullshit I have to put up with all the time. But I am very excited to record a little video when my Golux Golia arrives here. Even though she's reboxed, so clearly she is. She doesn't even look like she's in the original box, you know. She doesn't have the correct pose at all. But I'm still so excited. Like, I wanted her a lot, honestly. But I just looked at the price. And I was like, no, this is not going to be possible at all. And she did not sell out very fast like some other dolls did. But it was still not possible. The issue with Mattel is that they announced those collector dolls like a week before they drop. So it's like, you either already have the money in your bank account or you can't get them. And it really sucks. Like, if there was a little more margin, you could at least be like, okay, I'll save up over like the next 2 months. But no, just die, I guess. But so I knew I could not get her and was like, okay, fine. I love her. I want her so bad, but I can't. I will make peace with it. And here she was on Vinted, so I was like, I'll put her, she was 95 euros, so I was like, fine, I'll put her in my favorites, and I'll see, like, maybe if the price drops. And over time she kept like dropping a little bit, then a little bit, then a little bit, until she went from 80 to 70, I think, was the last discount. And since the description said you can make offers as long as you're reasonable, I was like, hey, do you want to sell this for 65? And the person said yes. I did not think they would say yes, but they did. They said yes. So with shipping and the bioprotection fee of Vinted, that was 70 euros. So 70 euros, barely more expensive than the original doll would have been. I got her like just best find of the year. You know what? Let's go with bald weevil doll. Like, we can make this cool. I think the Chucky's collector was not that great. Like, it's always like, oh, the characters have to have long hair. Like, why have super long hair on the Chucky doll if Chucky has this kind of bowl cut usually? Why have Tiffany's dress have those cheap looking blood splatters on her? Like, for the price, that it was crazy. But people bought her, people bought them, and I can understand kind of the attachment to Chucky as a brand or as a character, as a series of movies, but like, come on, stop letting yourself fall for like collector scams. Like, this is like collector scams. It's like companies presenting you with a kind of shitty product and being like, this is limited edition. But, well, I say this, but actually thinking about it, if they made like a Yanto doll, even if it was ugly, I would buy it. So maybe I should not be criticizing. They did make, I learned only like a month ago, that they did make dolls of Jack and Gwen. Made for like collectors, really, so really expensive and really ugly because they say they like copy the actor's likeness or something, but the dolls don't look like the actors. Like, they're very ugly. Like, that is not Jack. That does not even remotely look like him. The hair color isn't even right. And same with Gwen, like that does not look like her. So you know, for collector dolls, they do not look right. But they made Gwen and Jack, but no Yanto, even though the packaging has the Children of Earth theming to it. So, well, not only would those have been released way before I was into Torchwood, so I would not have been able to buy them anyway, but like, there's no Yanto. You have the packaging that has Yanto drawn on it, right here, and he's not even made as a doll. even if he was a really ugly doll, I would have gotten him. Because, like, I don't know, I would have found a way to get him. I would have saved up for so fucking long for like an ugly Yanta doll. All I have is the action figure. Which is also kind of ugly when you think about it. Like, again, does not really look like Yondu. But it is a smaller scale, so you can forgive them. Like, yeah, it's a small doll. There's no real shading painted on. So it's more difficult to make them actually look like the actors. Like, I think the mold itself isn't bad, but the lack of shading really makes it not look like Yanto. But you can be like, fine, this is a small scale, it's a cheap toy. Like, I think it was like 20 euros or something for like brand new. So it's really like fine, honestly. But the collector dolls that were like sold for $100 or something, and make an effort for the price point, make an effort. Honestly, I am going to have to start making custom figures or something, like found out how to make custom figures, like customized pop figures. I could figure that out, I think. Because a pop figure in itself is not too expensive. And I really just need to find one that has similar hair. So I would have to do like minimum molding on it. Well, because people make custom ones, like really great custom ones, but I don't have that kind of money. And I understand, it's like I love custom toys, I really understand why they're so expensive. Custom plushies, same. It's a lot of work, hours of work, it's obviously the materials, but I don't have money. Please, I'm broke. I should have all the money in the world so I can buy custom Yanto toys and plushies all the time. My mom is making me a crochet Yanto, but he only has two arms and a leg for now. He has nothing else. She is going a bit slow because she has work and stuff, so she doesn't have that much time to work on him. But it's fine, I will be patient. And I will have my crochet Yanto, and I'll sew him closes when I have him. I also wanted to make a Yanto Monster High, like in real life, because I have a Deuce doll. And I think if I just filled in the little cleft chin he has, I could make a Yanto, like just fill that out, repaint the face, and put a wig over the snakes, or well, cut off the snakes, put a wig, and then just sew little clothes, a little suit. Like, that is very much within my ability, I think. Because honestly, I don't really care about the male Monster High dolls. They they're kind of ugly, so people don't buy them, so they don't put effort in them, so they're even more ugly. And it's kind of a loop. I like G3 clothes, but then I realized I am going to forget about this guy. Like, I'm not going to like him as much as the girl dolls, so I'm not going to buy him. I did find G1 clothes in my stuff. Like, I thought I had lost him forever, and then I opened the drawer and he was in there. So I am keeping him. Heath I might sell on Vinted for like super cheap, because he doesn't even have clothes anymore. And Deuce, I think I'm gonna turn into a Yanto. But also there's a 3D printer at the library that is near my house. Well, not that near, I guess. It's like 30 minutes by bus. But there's a 3D printer at the library. And so basically what I'm thinking is learn 3D modeling and print out, like, I don't know, pony Yanto or normal Yanto or something. Technically, I guess I could make like a pop figure that is like straight up 3D printed, but I feel like that would just cost so much in materials, because I don't think the materials are free. I think you gotta pay for the materials. I think that it would cost more in like 3D printing materials to print a whole fake Yanto pop than it would to just get a normal pop and put clay or something on it for the little bits that would need changing. If only they had made official Torchwood pops. There's some Doctor Who ones, but there's no Torchwood, no Yanto. Honestly, it's insane to me how little Yanto official merch there is, because he was so popular. He still is so popular when you think about it. Like, everyone's favorite character is Yanto, and then new people watch Torchwood and their favorite is Yanto. Old fans, their favorite is Yanto. You could have made so much money out of just Yanto merch. Or throw in Jack as well if you want to really appeal to the like Fujoshi part of the fandom, I guess. But yeah, it's crazy. They could have made so much money making all kinds of pins and figures and everything, and no, there's just a couple trading cards and some generic Torchwood like full team merch, like posters and stuff, but there's really not that much merch overall. Like, imagine like life knife that you can display in your house. That would have been so cool. I could probably make a life knife out of clay or something. I have some polymer clay that we got out of storage this weekend. I could make life knife with that. I could make a mini Yanto with that. Not that big though, because those are really small packages. Though you can put like a tinfoil in the middle to have to use less clay for bigger figures, but still. Like, one thing that I want to do eventually, like probably, is get the Life Knife tattoo. That would be so cool. Well, first I want to get the Stag Beetle, but then maybe Life Knife. That would be so cool. It would be a Torchwood tattoo that is not that obvious. And I think since the design of the knife in itself is cool, like, even if I stopped liking Torchwood, I don't think I would, like, think, oh, this is so ugly now. Like, it has such a cool shape. You get that as a tattoo, and even if later you're like, oh, I don't really care about Torchwood anymore, you can still, like, appreciate the shape of the thing, you know? Like, you can still be like, oh, that's a cool prop, that's a cool design they used in that TV show, even if I don't particularly care about the TV show anymore. Yeah, that could be nice as well, but I think in the show the stab wounds just look like regular stab wounds, because there was just so much blood around, like, on the character's clothes, that you could not tell anything. So I think the knife itself is more recognizable. But first I want a stag beetle on my stomach so that when I wear crop tops, you can see the stag beetle. That's my dream tattoo. For when I have money. Like, lots of money, like a job. I need to advertise my commissions more places, because I want to go to a con in June. But obviously, well, the tickets I can buy. I already have enough money for that. But you don't go to a con with that extra money to buy stuff at the stalls. Like, that would not be cool. So I need to save money to go buy stuff there. Because obviously I have my allowance, that's pretty big now, but I also want to keep buying stuff and going out with friends and eating out and stuff like that. So I want to keep some of that money from my allowance to do fun stuff. So yeah, basically, yeah, I need to advertise all those nice commissions. I put it on my 1,000 followers side blog, thinking, okay, there's gotta be at least one person in there who has money that they want to spend. No one has sent me a message. No one. People have shared the post, at least, but no one sent me a message. Please, I need your money. I need all your money. All of it. All the money in the world. Like, I will draw anything. I'll draw a dog on an airplane if you want. I don't know. Maybe I need to learn how to draw porn or something. Yeah, that would probably work better, but it's just hard to draw. Okay, that's the outfit done. Might have pockets might be nice though. Like we all deserve pockets in our clothes, like those are so important. Monster High often has like really detailed shoes, but I honestly don't really know how I would like draw Weevil shoes. I'm gonna go on the wiki, TARDIS wiki, and the new wiki is really nice because it's not fandom anymore, so it's less ad-ridden and ugly, but it is slow. Trying to look at Weevil lore to see if I can get inspiration. That arm is so not straight. I opened Discord to do something. Oh, right. Because someone, I remember someone being like, oh, talking about the Torchwood Archives, the book, the black one, that's all those little tidbits about the episode as a sort of fake in-universe investigation. They were talking about this and I said, oh, this information is not gonna be on TARDIS Wiki because TARDIS Wiki does not consider the Torchwood Archives valid source. But I could not find where they explained it, because I checked on the page that explained valid sources and wasn't on it. I checked on the page for the Torchwood Archives, it wasn't on it. And I finally found a bit on this page that explains it. So they don't consider it a source for the wiki, for like in-universe pages of the wiki, because it's not narrative, like it's just little files coupled together. It's not like a story, even though there's a vague story in it of a guy that breaks into Torchwood, takes a bunch of files, puts them into a book and tries to publish it. And Torchwood does not let it get published, of course. But yeah. Anyway. I am very thirsty, so I will get some water. And I will be right back. Yes, I have a very good microphone that picks up basically anything in this room and even stuff from outside sometimes. One time I was voice calling a friend and I think I had the window open a little bit or something and she heard a dog barking outside that even I could not hear. The microphone picked it up. Crazy to me, honestly. Like, yeah. So I read up a little bit on weevil lore to remind myself. Yes, they used to, did you know weevils used to be human beings? Like, there's a story where they have a thing called Object One, which is supposedly the oldest thing they have in the Torchwood archives, and it turned sailors into weevils. And you know, throughout the entire show, they're always like, oh, they come from the rift, they come from the rift, they come from the rift, but actually they don't. Like, later on, the writers made it so that they don't come from the rift. And I think it's so interesting because it's like the limitations of the Torchwood team's knowledge. Like, they all think they come from the rift because that's what makes the most sense to them. Like, oh, there's a bunch of aliens. We don't know how they arrived here. So they probably just came in through the rift. Like, they've been here as long as we can remember. They've had plenty of time to reproduce, create entire societies in the sewers and stuff. It makes sense to them, but it's not what happened. And in Tube Strike, which is the monthly audio that was released in March with Yanto, which is why I listened to it so quickly. They're in the underground in London, and there's a weevil infestation, and there's weevils described wearing like human clothes, not just those jumpsuits, like dresses and hats and scarves. And the characters, the Torchwood characters, so like Yanto and Tommy, Tommy being from Torchwood 1, so this is Torchwood 1 era, this is why they're in London also. They think that those are like trophies, you know, like they came from the rift and they killed people and they took like trophies, but it's not. It's like implied that they used to be people, but Tommy is so focused on like, oh, they come from the rift, is like, oh, it's they're from Wales or something, like. And it's crazy because there's a random like civilian who thinks that those used to be people, and he's the one who's right. And all the characters like, no, they did not used to be people, they are aliens. But they did used to be people. And like, genius, honestly, to really highlight how little Torchwood actually knows. Even though they think they know everything, they really don't. And I think there might be a couple times in the audio where Yanto kind of hesitates about whether or not they're really from the rift. But I would need to re-listen. I only listened to it once. And it is like genius, honestly. It's written by Gareth David Lloyd, that's why it's genius. He always delivers. A video I really want to make is sort of an analysis of Yanto's autism, specifically in the things that Gareth David Lloyd wrote. But the issue is that, well, first of all, I would need to re-listen to all the audios that he wrote and take notes as I'm listening. But like, sometimes I listen to something thinking, oh, I need details on this specific moment, so I'm gonna listen to the whole thing while I'm at it, and I just fucking forget that I'm listening for this specific thing, so I don't really pay attention to the moment in question. It's like, and then I'm like, oh wait, I forgot I was doing it for this specific thing. And the other thing is that I think if you're gonna make a video like that, that's about one specific writer, like the least I can do is try to contact him and try to like ask him questions, you know? But for that, I would need to take notes, try to think exactly of what questions I want to ask, and then the most difficult part is actually contact him and be like, hey, would you be willing to answer some questions? And that would be so scary. But I think, well, first I want to do some other videos that require a bit less work. And then I think I can do this one. So I think like I have time to to sort of mentally prepare myself that I'm gonna have to go on Twitter and try to like add a celebrity, like, hey, do you wanna help me with my video? Hi. Yeah, there's so many videos that I want to make about Torchwood, like some are analysis more and some are more just like me ranting angrily about things in this fandom. Like, why do people consider Gento to be the be-all and all of Torchwood? Like, Jack could never love anyone except Yanto, and like, everyone they loved before was not real love and all that bullshit. Like, why are people like this? Like, I wanted to make a whole video about this. I wanted to make a video about Gwen's bisexuality specifically. Like, people, well, there's not much on this one, I guess, because it's a pretty simple reasoning. First of all, RTT said she is bisexual, so she is. Like, that is, it is that easy. And some other stuff like Cyberwoman that I want to talk about. But yeah, the biggest ones, honestly, are really Yanto's autism in Gareth David Lloyd's work specifically, and a review of every single Yanto audio that has ever been released. That one would be huge, because there's, how many of them are there? Hold on, I'll check that one. Stories filtered by character Yanto Jones and audio drama. There's like, there's 33 of them for now, and we're going to get two more monthly range Yantos in April and May, plus an entire Torchwood One box set, so that's 3 stories in May as well, and I think all 3 of them have Yanto in it, so that's gonna be like 30, we're gonna be at 38, and you know, they keep releasing new Yantos because Gareth David Lloyd doesn't have much else to do, honestly. Like, I know it's a bit mean to say that, but he does not have much else to do. And also, everyone loves Yanto. Those probably sell out so well. So I would have to review at least 38 of them. Like, that would be long. And again, I would need to take notes as I'm listening to, like, what little bits that I want to put in the video specifically as highlights. What do I want to say about each story? It would take so long. Longer than the video, but you're not being autistic, honestly. So shoes, let's try to think of cool designs for the shoes. They used to be sailors, maybe something related to sailors, maybe something related to death, because they have this whole lore about worshipping death. I could go for sort of a skull in the front for the whole death thing. Not very original, I guess. But do I care? No. okay, this is kind of ugly so far. What am I doing? Shrews are so difficult because it's like Monster High's whole thing that they have detailed shoes, but you have to think of the details you want to work to draw. That is not easy. Yeah, I remember you telling me that. Yay, food. Why is my... Never mind. what's what? The glove image I put, or? Yeah, basically there's a whole plot line in Torchwood about a glove that can resurrect people. And this is it. It's like a metal glove, like some kind of knight thing, medieval thing. And I'm gonna use it as inspiration for the Weevil's collector shoes. Because they also have sort of a connection to the glove. And also, I don't know what else I can do for the. But honestly, might just do the shoes later, because that shit is difficult. I'm not a shoe designer. I'm not even the closest designer. I like drawing the clothes, but I don't like having to design them. Well, you know, Monster High does like turning regular monsters into like super fashionable versions. So, Weevil is turning into like super cool, the super cool version. No normal jumpsuit, you get short sleeves, you get accessories. This is like Janet's glow up Wee Villa. I'm putting in the pointy teeth, though, like. Let's try to do the face so that it looks similar, but also works without hair. First, I'm gonna draw one eye. So I can copy it over there. I'm gonna do one side and then just copy paste it, because this is not gonna work. think I'm going to end the stream here because my back is starting to hurt and I'm kind of falling asleep at my desk also. So I hope you all had fun watching. And maybe I will finish this in the next stream. Maybe not. Who knows? Bye.